everyone, in this video we are going to talk about IoT cards and OTMI. So guys, if you not subscribe my channel yet, so please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon. So guys, let's start our video. So first we discuss the introduction of the Arch of IOTA. So the Arch of IOTA is a continuation of ascending IOTA at the sternal angle. As you can see on the diagram, this is an OTMI of the IOTA. So it is from the ascending IOTA starting at the sternum angle. It connects ascending and descending IOTA. As you can see on the diagram, there is a ascending IOTA and the descending IOTA, and between them there is a arch of IOTA. Arch is over the root of the left lung, situated in superior mediastinum behind the manubrium. It is situated in the mediastinum behind manubrium. Summit of arch reaches level of middle of manubrium. So this is the arch of IOTA, that is a continuation of the ascending IOTA and present at the sternal angle. Next we discuss course of the arch of IOTA. So it begin as continuation of the ascending IOTA, we discuss in the introduction of the arch of IOTA, and behind the right second chondrosternal joint, and then passes up back and left in front of bifurcation of the trachea. So as you can see on the diagram, it is started from the sternal angle and then passes back and left in front of bifurcation of the trachea. Then finally turn backward and downward behind the left bronchus and continues as descending IOTA at the lower border of the T4 vertebra. So it is a continuation of the ascending IOTA and as a descending IOTA at the lower border of the T4 vertebra, as you can see on the diagram. So this is the course of the arch of IOTA. Now we discuss the relations of arch of IOTA. So firstly we discuss relation its anterior and to the left. So as you can see on the diagram, this is a view of arch of IOTA. So the relation of it, left pleura and the lung, left phrenic nerve, left cardiac nerve, superior cervical cardiac sim trunk, left vagus, left superior IC vein. So this is the anterior and to the left relation of the arch of IOTA. Now the second is posterior and to the right. So trachea with the deep cardiac plexus, esophagus, left recurrent laryngeal nerve, thoracic duct and the vertebral column. So these are the posterior and to the right relation of the arch of IOTA, as you can see on the diagram. Now the third one is superior relation of the arch of IOTA. So the superior relation of it, brachiocephalic trunk, left common carotid artery, left subclavian artery and the left bronchocephalic vein. So these are the superior relation of the arch of IOTA, and the next is inferior relation. So the inferior relations, left bronchus, bifurcation of the pulmonary trunk, leg arteriosum, left recurrent laryngeal nerve and superior cardiac plexus. So these are the inferior relation of arch of IOTA. It is important you have to learn diagram first, then it is easy to explain everything. Now we discuss the branches of arch of IOTA. So the branches of arch of IOTA are right brachiocephalic trunk, that is divided into the right common carotid artery and the right subclavian artery. As you can see on the diagram, there is a brachiocephalic artery that is divided into the two artery. Now the second one is left common carotid artery, third one is left subclavian artery, and there is a occasional carotidema A and the vertebra A. So these are the branches of the arch of IOTA, as you can see on the diagram. So firstly we discuss introduction of the arch of IOTA, next we discuss the course of IOTA, then relation and then branches. Now we discuss the applied anatomy or clinical anatomy of a arch of IOTA. So first one is patent ductus arterios. So it is a heart defect that occurs when the ductus arterios does not close at the birth. So the temporary fetal blood vessel that connect the IOTA and the pulmonary artery, that is ductus arteriosus, when it not close at the birth, so it leads to the patent ductus arterios. As you can see on the diagram, there is a defect in that vessels. Now the second one is coarctation of IOTA, that is a congenital narrowing of upper descending thoracic IOTA adjacent to the side of attachment of the ductus arterios. So in this, there is a narrowing of the descending thoracic aorta that leads to the coarctation of aorta. As you can see on the diagram, this is a coarctation of aorta. Now the third one is aortic aneurysm. So you can see there is a normal aorta and the aortic aneurysm. The aneurysm, there is an enlargement of aorta occurs. So it is termed as a aortic aneurysm. So guys, in this video we discuss anatomy of arch of aorta. Hope you like this video. So please like, share, subscribe my channel. Thank you.